Hi, this is Joseph Tan here from goodmonday.com. Now, how do we add hands and feet to the mission of your organization or your team? How do we actually make the mission becomes a walking and talking reality? There are four areas that your mission need to touch. Number one, how your mission affects your hiring, how your mission affects your firing, how your mission affect your partners, and also how your mission gets in touch with the community. So these are the four areas that you need to consider if you want your mission to have hands and feet. In hiring, there is the internal hire that you can make, and there is also the external hire that you can also execute. Now, internal hiring is important because this is part of your people development in the organization. In other words, existing employees are always constantly thinking about what's the next step for them, what's the next progression in their career. And if every progression is given to external hires, then this can be quite demotivating to present-day employees. That is why it is always a wise human resource development strategy to constantly offer opportunities to internal candidates first before it is opened up to the open marketplace. Give opportunities for existing employees whom you have already hired, who is already loyal to the company, for them to grow and progress with the company so that when the company grows, they also can grow along as well. Constantly make sure that any positions that you create contributes to the mission. The positions that you create should bring you steps closer to the mission of your organization. Don't be driven by profits alone. Always remind yourself, what is the purpose of our mission? Now, external talents are also necessary when there are no internal candidates that are qualified, because external talents do bring in a fresh perspective, and external talent do bring in additional competencies that is required by the organization. And external talent can also provide competent leadership to drive the organization forward. But do remember, any external talent that you hire must drive the organization closer to the mission. Beware of external leaders that come in that actually lead the organization astray to their own personal mission or agenda. It must always be aligned with the existing organization mission. The next area is an interesting one. You can fire. Now, you can either fire a person out of the organization or you can fire a person up. So what's the difference? Now, firing a person up means that you ought to have a talent management program. You ought to have a program that can recognize talented employees and learn how to further fire them up. Learn how to further develop them so that their talent can contribute to the mission of the organization. Many companies have talent management programs that are isolated from their vision and mission. You can never be too over-communicating when it comes to your organization's mission. Make sure that the mission and the vision is incorporated into the syllabus and the curriculum of the talent management program so that employees who are talented and fired up can see the connection and they can actually connect the dots. That can be very motivating to their future growth in the organization. There are times when you need to make the difficult decision of firing someone out of the organization. This is when expectations are not met. So it is the duty of the leader to set clear expectations. Not only that, but the expectation should be aligned with the mission of the organization as well. Because if expectations are not clear, people then define their own standards of productivity. And that is not acceptable in an organization that wants to move forward with their vision and mission. There is an interesting dynamics at play here, because if action is not taken against the non-performers, it will affect the morale and the motivation level of the performers. Because if those who are performing do not see that action is taken against the non-performers, then they will see no reason why they should perform at a higher level, since people who do not perform are treated almost the same as they are. So there must be some form of discrimination as far as performance is concerned. Now, I'm not saying that we should discriminate against the worth of an individual, but we should discriminate performance, because rewarding right performance will help to motivate talented people, especially if the standards of the performance are aligned with the company mission. This will help drive things forward. Your mission should affect your partners as well. Now, who are your partners? Your partners are your clients or your customers, and also your suppliers. Your suppliers and your clients must be a part of your mission. Most of the time when it comes to communicating with clients and suppliers, we talk a lot about cost. But have you ever considered talking about the cost, the C-A-U-S-E, as to why your organization exists and why your clients and your suppliers will actually benefit from being a part of the cause, and what part they can contribute towards realizing this great cause that your organization is a part of? For example, the suppliers need to realize the critical role that they are involved in helping to ensure that clients' needs are met. In other words, you need to show appreciation to the suppliers. Appreciate them for the way that they contribute to the mission of the organization in fulfilling the needs of the client. Suppliers should not be taken for granted. Make your suppliers a part of your organization growth. Get them involved in the planning process, because they are a critical link to having your organization fulfill the overall mission. And what about clients? They are more than just a money-making machine. They are there as your partners. Get them involved in your mission as well. Communicate to them constantly as to how you can help them meet their needs. And in the process, it also fulfills your mission as well. Your clients must be a part of your organization's mission, because they are the reason for your existence. Get them involved even in the strategic planning process, because that will create a partnership of ownership. Finally, there is the element of the community. And in reaching out to the community with your mission, it should touch the area of education, and it should also touch the area of needs within the community around you. You know, in order to build a pipeline of future employees and leaders, you need to be reaching out to the schools and colleges, because these are where the bright leaders of tomorrow are residing, and they need to be aware of the industry you're in. They need to be aware of your company mission. Get them to be excited about what your company is doing, so that when they graduate, when they go into the marketplace, they will consider joining your organization. And more than that, they are considering joining your organization's mission. Because young people today are looking for meaningful jobs. They are not just looking for a way to pay the bills, but they want to join an organization who resonate with their belief and with their purpose. So if you make clear your mission early on, then there is more opportunities for alignment between their personal motivation and your company's mission. Next is your corporate social responsibility. Be sensitive to the needs of the community around you. There could be certain people groups, certain economical disadvantage that people are facing, certain crisis, certain community needs that you need to be aware of. And it will be so wonderful if your corporate social responsibility is incorporated into your mission as well. Because regardless of what industry you're in, you're always in the people business, and caring for the people around you helps to add heart and soul to your organization, a very much needed feature in today's corporate world. So there you have it, four ways as to how to add hands and feet to your mission: to hire right, both internally and externally, to fire up and to fire out, to partner with both suppliers and clients, and to reach out to the community in the area of education and being sensitive to their particular needs. In this way, you would have added the walking factor to what you are talking about on a regular basis concerning your mission. And if you consistently act on these four areas, then your company mission will be more than just a piece of document on the wall. It will be part of your organization's daily culture. Think about it. This is Joseph Tan here from goodmonday.com. If you're interested to find out more about my leadership development programs and services, check out the website, goodmonday.com. I also offer online coaching services. Check out the details at goodmonday.com/coaching. I look forward to having a conversation with you then. Thanks for watching.